As a key pillar of the Ugandan economy, the agriculture sector is a critical driver of economic growth and poverty alleviation. Uganda's agricultural sector is dominated by smallholder farmers with low levels of productivity. The sector is highly exposed to threats, including weather changes, biological challenges, poor infrastructure, fluctuating prices, and market perils. This overabundance of risk suppresses appetite for investment in the sector. Even with the sector's massive contribution to the economy, farmers' access to finance remains a major constraint. Recognizing agricultural finance's critical role in the transformation agenda, the government is supporting several initiatives to unlock agricultural finance. To manage the financial impacts of production shocks, the government of Uganda seeks to use agricultural insurance to de-risk rural lending and expand access to rural credit for smallholder farmers.
Hello, welcome to the Harvest Money Show. Tonight we are going to discuss a very interesting topic, that is agriculture financing. We shall look at financing in the agriculture sector. That is a key, you know, interest of most farmers. Most people want to know where they can get money to actually, you know, advance their agricultural business and profit out of it. But agricultural financing is always a challenge for most farmers. Today, we are looking at financing coming in from Bank of Uganda. They have a small recovery fund for agriculture and the agriculture credit facility for most farmers who might want money to, you know, inject into their agribusiness and profit out of it. And we shall be talking to the head of disbursement of the agriculture credit facility, that is Prosy Namala, to tell us what kind of financing Bank of Uganda has and how you can access it as a farmer to grow your agri business. So come with me as we talk to Prosy Namala on how to get financing for your agricultural business. And as we get there, I must welcome all of you. Welcome back from the Harvest Money Expo 2023 that happened from Friday until Sunday. That was last week at the Kololo Airstrip. For now, we talk to Prosy Namala about agricultural financing from Bank of Uganda and how it can profit farmers in this country. And well, today we are talking about a unique subject, a subject that many farmers have interest in, and that is agricultural financing. Many farmers are always looking for that money which they can use to invest in their agribusiness and make sure they create wealth out of farming. And tonight we have the head of disbursement at the Bank of Uganda, that is the agricultural credit facility, that is Prosy Namala. She is going to tell us all about agricultural financing as is organized in Bank of Uganda. So welcome to the show, Prosy. Would like to know, what is it about agricultural financing that has been, has been organized in Bank of Uganda?
Thank you so much. As I had been earlier introduced, my name is Namala Prosy. I work at Bank of Uganda under the Agriculture Credit Facility Division. We do support the entire agriculture food value chain, all the way from the farm to production. A farm, how? On farm activity, you have maybe with your capacity, you can only do 2 acres, but you have land which is over certain or whatever, but some of it you can do some agriculture, others it's a bush. We can support you to do bush clearing, do restocking, do pesticides and whatever, all on farm activities, we do support them. Then production. Maybe you need a truck that can carry your produce from the garden to the market. We can support you with that. We also support you into production. Production, how? You are adding value to your commodity. Be it small, be it on a large scale, you're into value addition. Whereby, for instance, you need a mill to mill the maize, to mill the grain, you're doing value addition. we can support you to do, to buy the machinery, we can support you to do the infrastructure where the machinery is going to sit. We can even, you can say you're talking on a high end. Some people, I was here at the show and someone said, but for me, I do juice. Eh? I supply juice to the nearby restaurants, but I do it with just a mere blender and a few mechanical ways. But now I need a big, I need something bigger, a juice processor which can process like say 200 liters. Even that micro borrower we can support. We can support you in all the agricultural value chain, other than buying land, paying off old loans. Another one which we don't support is trade, say I buy matoke from somewhere, then I transport it to the market, then I sell. No, we don't support that kind of agricultural trade. Maybe I have an input dealer, I do stock chemicals, acaricides and what to supply them to the farmers. We don't support those other trade, agriculture related, other than grain trade. For grain traders, we support, because you're mopping up excess grain from the market, then you have a market where you can sell. Maybe others are doing into value addition. We also have this component of value addition of the agricultural produce. For instance, you're adding value to bananas. Eh? You're cutting them. You're doing crisps. We support. So the best way, many people have been asking, how do I access? You have to go through your bank. The banks which we regulate as Bank of Uganda. This is a government fund, the Agricultural Credit Facility. It's a partnership between Government of Uganda and the banks. You can ask where does BOU come in? BOU come in because we are the custodian of the government accounts. So we act as an administrator and also have a supervision arm whereby it helps us to go and check on our loans, you see. So that's how we come in. The loans, we extend them to the borrowers. The final borrower should be charged a rate which does not exceed 12% maximum. For a final borrower who is into those other agriculture related activity, for grain traders, the loan should not exceed 15%. If you know how to talk like you, you can say, no, you know, you can talk to your bank and you negotiate a lower rate. But that is our rate, the maximum 12% for these other agriculture related, for grain trade, 15% per annum. The processing charge, we agreed with our banks, it should not exceed a 0.5%. Okay? Then other things, the terms are really concessionary. You can agree like a sugarcane farmer. Can't be paying monthly. You can talk to your bank that I'm a sugarcane farmer. I'll pay you at the end of when I've harvested. I am into chicken farming. I do broilers. I'll be paying after 3 months when I've sold the chicken. We have a grace period. The grace period for the farmer, we agreed it should be between 6 to 3 years. 6 months, for instance, I'll give an example of a borrower who is into chicken layers. Don't expect the borrower to pay before even the eggs are produced. So, unless you have other alternative sources of what? Funding, okay? But we give a grace period. Actually, the grace period, it is up to 3 years to give that provision for people who are importing agro-machinery. They are going to do value addition. So we gave an allowance. By the time a person imports a machinery, setting it up to put it into production, it takes some time. That's why we have that grace period between 3 to 6 months. The repayment period should be below 8 years. as I've given you an example, there are those ones who are into value addition, serious value addition. They have to do importation by the time they start to produce, you see. But for grain trade, maximum tenure is 2 years. Those are the few terms for our facility. The best way to do it, I actually encourage people out there who really into agriculture. Most people, they think agriculture is so much informal and what. It is okay, but there is a point called start. You can start to formalize. If you're a borrower there, a farmer who has not been banking, start to bank. If you've not been keeping records, start to keep records. If you've not been doing some activity, do some activity, you know, on your land. So that when you come to the bank, if you've not been taking records that I sell milk to the nearby restaurants, you don't have a record. Start to record, you see. So when the banks come to do an evaluation, it is easier for them.
Well, before maybe I ask you about the conditionalities you set for the commercial banks, I would want to know the different, you know, products that you have in terms of financing, which you extend to these commercial banks that, you know, the farmers that you want to support can look at and perhaps get that money to grow their, you know, agribusiness.
Okay, thank you so much. In addition to the agriculture, we also support, you know, most... Whenever we come to such shows, they used to tell us, you only support agriculture. What of me who is into a restaurant, me who is into decoration? How can you support me? Good enough, we thank the president, we thank the government that really, and I think also we thank COVID, because there is a small business recovery fund which was set up recently post-COVID to support businesses, such businesses, which were affected by COVID. These businesses, other than agriculture, BT, what, there are so many, decoration, nursery schools, people are into all those other businesses other than agriculture. There is a fund that was created by government and financial institutions whereby you can go and easily access these funds. Actually, the terms and conditions are so favorable. We want every person who has been out there struggling with their business to come into this small business recovery fund to recover. You know, I'll give an example like schools. During even like nursery schools, even during the little time the government opened during COVID, they had to close. They say the nursery schools should not open. So you have to go to the bank. You explain to them your ordeal that, you know, I want a small business recovery fund. I used to be into this kind of business. However, before I was performing like this, during COVID, everything was down. Now I want to start again. Maybe, for instance, I've given a nursery school. You can say I need to buy chairs, tables, what, to pay rent, to whatever, to refurbish the school again, to paint. We can give you that money. The banks, we've already talked to the banks and they are aware. Some are even struggling with old loans. The terms, we've even revised them, that they can pay off even some of the old loans that you're struggling with. How does government define a small business? A small business is that business which can, on average, have an annual turnover of 300 million. And you can employ a minimum of two people. Eh? Two people that maybe I have a shop, I have even this guy who helps me to offload things. You know, it's a source of employment, you know. Eh? To offload and load things is also a source of employment. So minimum, we agreed with the banks to extend to borrowers who can employ minimum two people to 49 people. So the rate at which the borrower should get the money should not exceed 10%. Okay? The processing charge is 0.5%. You can also get the money maximum 200 million, okay? So So you, as I explained to you, you can also get a money which is maximum 200 million. That is averagely, that's what we can offer now. So really, all businesses which are out there and you're really struggling, this is the time for you to hook onto this new product and you have it so that you recover fully and you do the business. Okay?
So now you talk about, this money being accessible to different people in business. So the small businesses, given that COVID struck recently, and you have some money for them through their commercial banks. But the thing is, most people feel like the banks are charging so much interest on this money. Much as you say it shouldn't exceed 10%, people accessing this money maybe at over 10%. Interest, and people are quite downcast. They're heartbroken. Yeah, like, shall we ever make money if we have all these high interest rates? So under such circumstance, how do I, as a small business person, as a farmer, come to the bank and, you know, and let you know my grievances that the interest rate is so much? Is there anything you can do as the central bank for this small business person?
It's two in one. Any aggrieved person in the, maybe the bank cheated you, they don't want to give you back your security, whatever, they overcharged you or whatever, you can come to Bank of Uganda, to our branches, which are spread in different regions of the country. You write to our complaint desk in supervision and you put in your complaint. Those supervision people do a very good work. They'll go do the due diligence, check what happened, they ask the bank what happened and what, and there will be fairness both to the borrower and also to the lender. And actually, before you sign on any loan, like this one of SCF, I've been telling people here, for and agricultural credit, when they give you an offer letter and you have to accept, please look. First, you read through. You know, these borrowers, at times they come to the bank when they are, that very day, they don't even read, So it's better you read through, say, okay, I asked for agriculture credit offered by Bank of Uganda. I know very well that the lending rate should not exceed 12%. Why is it here on the letter? It's 24, okay? Why is it that the processing charge is 2? All any other, yet I know it is supposed to be 0.5%. You have to read through before you sign, okay? In event you sign, you've already made a commitment with a bank. Either you go with the 24 or you do the 12. You can talk to your bank, Actually, in banks, there are hierarchy. That all loan officer there, he has a supervisor. All you go to the branch personnel, the branch manager. If the loan officer doesn't listen to you, talk to the branch manager. If the branch manager can't listen to you, you know, they have a head office. You can come to Bank of Uganda and we find a way on how to resolve this issue amicably, and there is fairness. And actually there are some guidelines which we are offered to the supervised financial institutions whereby the borrower has to be explained everything related to the loan he or she is taking. Okay? So that's why there is a document called Key KFD. Okay? The Key Facts document. It explains to you everything. The loan, how much are they charging, how much are they charging, and what is the lending rate. Yeah.
Interesting. Well, now that we've talked about agricultural financing and the interests that come with it, we would like to talk to Prosy about, accessibility when it comes to this financing, and also, accessing Bank of Uganda just in case things are not working out. You want somewhere to go put out your complaint and have the issue addressed. So Prosy, how easy is it to access these loans in Bank of Uganda? Do I need some sort of security? And if I put in my security and somebody doesn't want to give it back to me, how easy is it for me to come to Bank of Uganda and complain?
Okay, let me start with accessibility of these loans. Both the Small Business Recovery Fund and the Agricultural Credit Facility, you have to be with a bankable project, you know. I've been here and people have so many things in their head, which are very, very brilliant. So I've told them to go home, craft those ideas, think through them, and write them to see how bankable it is. That is number one on how to access. Number two, you have to be with an active account. Some accounts are dormant, people don't want to bank. He banked last year in January when someone promised him money. So the account has to be active. You have to be with a good credit history. Yeah? Are you this kind of borrower who had a loan in Pride on a certain bank which ran bad and now you're running here for the loan to be? So you have to be with a good credit history. Also, this money is not for free. It has to be paid back. You have to have it has to be fully secured. You have to provide an adequate security because the government provide a portion and also the bank contributes a portion. So we need that assurance that really in case the loan goes bad, it will be recovered. Maybe another thing which I didn't talk about was the block allocation. There are these borrowers who don't have adequate security and they need not a lot of money, that is below 20 million. They can be put under block allocation. Maybe the bank can assess that this borrower has been banking well, has a good credit history, the character is good, you have a chibanja, all that can be under block allocation. Those micro borrowers can be catered for both in agriculture credit and also in small business recovery fund.
Maybe before you go so far, you could just simplify for us when you say block allocation. What is it?
Okay, block allocation. Borrowers below 20 million, who need money below 20 million, the bank can aggregate them. Say a person from Tenjeru needs 5 million. Another one in Komamboga needs 20. So they group them, they aggregate them and send one list to BOU for refinance, okay? It could be even a cooperative, where a bank goes to a cooperative and extend credit to all the members, They can group it. At the end of the day, find that this block of people, have been given over like 300 million or in totality. Someone got 7 million, another one got 700, another one got 10, another one 20. Those ones has gone into that group and blocked them up and they come to Bank of Uganda for refinance. You've talked about for treasury bills, how can someone be helped in to get these treasury bills and treasury bonds? You can come to Bank of Uganda. There is a counter. You go through that Kampala Road. You tell them, I want to go to counter 14. The person, usually there is a person there waiting for you from 8 up to 5 to give you assistance on how to access. Other people say, no, Bank of Uganda, we find they are policemen, they chase us, what? Bank of Uganda is a very approachable place because we also have a library, with a lot of wealth and books. You can write to the communication department, our director communication, that on such and such a day, I need to come and read over this period of time. I want to be in your library to have time to research and read. They'll give you access. Or like this agriculture credit and whatever, you can come to Bank of Uganda, you tell the policeman or the security people that, you know, I've come here, I want to know more about Small Business Recovery Fund. They'll love you in, they'll call me, I'll come all the way from Levayam in my Kakondo, and come and I attend to you, okay? Right. Yes, it's a very approachable bank, okay? But also it needs, say, we need security when we are there, right. You know, we are in the center of the town. So we need security, but if you know what you've come to do, exactly, you'll be helped. People at the reception are very good people. They welcome you. They will call us. Anyone you want, they will call that person and come and give you assistance you need. Mm. Thank you so much.
Well, that is it from Prosine Amala, the head of disbursement, agriculture credit facility at Bank of Uganda. I think you've heard her. She has explained everything in regard to agricultural financing, the plans they have at Bank of Uganda, the money that they have that they give to you as a small business person or a farmer that goes through your commercial bank. And one thing I picked from her that was very crucial is that it is important to read all about these financing facilities. Before you go to your commercial bank and get this money, you must read, because the minute you accept to take that loan under a certain condition, then the condition will remain. But as always, if you feel aggrieved, she says Bank of Uganda is very accessible. You can always go there and put across your complaints. You don't fear those policemen you meet at the gate. Just talk to them, tell them what your need is, and they will help you access the office that you want. So that is it for the Harvest Money Show tonight. Until next time, goodbye.